ready. You know, we're gonna know something soon. That's why they're ready. That's why they're here.
It's very good. It's good for the fighters to get paid
really
to
good,
be.
Man. Really good. I said today, we already, we already knew it was in the works.
Yeah.
We already knew about a few days that were gonna happen, but. Today was
official.
Today is official.
June 11th. And it's Vegas. You could drive.
25th.
Yeah, they have. The commissioner already approved the first two.
But top rank bucks today came out already.
Yeah, it's two per week. Two
shows. Want to make sure that the first one's going
good.
Yeah.
Two per week.
That's why they couldn't go straight into like Shakur's not. He's fighting, but he's not defending. It's how they find like a 130 and then 10 round fight.
Just to stay busy. This is good.
No, just for them to make sure that everything comes out.
Everything good.
I'm sure
everything comes out good.
Did they announce where the fights are taking place yet?
No. Because
this is what I heard. Maybe MGM. Maybe the Wynn, or maybe at the UFC Center.
Well, I don't know where. No, they haven't told us that. They haven't told us that. We just know it's gonna be in Vegas, and they already announced it 2 days.
About 135. Who to one? Durant or Mayweather?
Durant.
What do you think, Pita?
Look, Castillo.
I didn't get to see Durant too much.
Castillo, a lot of us thought he beat him. Maidana, a lot of us thought he beat him. Durant was the fucking worst beast than those guys. Like, Durant would knock those guys out, I think. Durant was a beast.
What about Maidana and Conor McGregor?
On a fight?
Yeah, boxing. In a fight, boxing.
Maidana would fucking destroy that guy.
Do you remember the scorecards from the first Mayweather fight?
No, one of them was strong.
114, 114, 116, 112, and 117, 111. For the rematch.
Yeah. Chavez or Arguello. That would have been a very, very good fight. At 135 or 140, that would have been I don't know, man. Arguello was fucking sick, man. I still pick Chavez. I'd pick Chavez on that one.
Who do you think is the most underrated fighter today? Like, who has the most talent but gets the least attention, the least credit?
I'm not sure.
Who?
Ugas is up there. Ugas is up there with, he doesn't get that lot of attention. They don't really talk to him. They don't talk about him a lot as a top one through it. And they don't give him a shot for a reason.
I think one of the fighters in that level is like Jose Ramirez, who's a superstar. He has two belts, and nobody really mentions him when they talk about the superstar. He's not on pound-for-pound list, and he could be.
Well, because there's so many weight divisions, and there's so many very talented fighters, But Jose Ramirez is...
He's up there.
He's got two titles,
He's going to have four titles after fighting Josh Taylor.
Hopefully we do. We do get
Taylor,
a shot.
For great, really good fight.
But
there's a lot of fights out there for Jose, but he already got the Reaches win. I think a couple more solid wins like that, put him up there, put him on those lists.
You mean he fought Hooker? Regis Taylor.
I know. He beat Hooker the way he did. I think that puts that another two wins like that against solid names puts him up there.
135 Chavez versus Mayweather.
Mayweather.
Aaron Pryor or Chavez?
Man, see, those are fucking tough decisions, man. Because Aaron Pryor was.
He hit hard.
But he was on drugs.
How do you know?
Because he tested positive for one. I guess our way.
The water story.
The water. Give me the water. Give the one that I
made. No, the other one.
No, the other one. Like that one. Chavez would have fucking had to work his ass, hard to be able to beat those guys. But I pick Chavez.